por comprar um rucksack. Bom, né? Solta. Quer dizer, caiu com o rucksack.
Banho. out for a stroll, are we?
Thank you. Vãi cả lìn lại còn vậy, đi mẹ cái này hơi hơi đi mẹ hơi hơi ảo đi mẹ cái này rất mới đi đi cái này độ mới cao. Bắt gần lồn tiếng Malai.
I'm gonna break your legs, nice and slow.
this then, eh? What's this then, eh? a manhunter.
Thank you. No problem, man. No problem. I've just started, and this is 0.76, which is the still in development version that should be out in just a couple of days, and I am just testing to see if it's working or not, and maybe find some bugs or balancing issues and stuff.
What's this then, eh?
I don't always get the missing textures problem, probably because sometimes you might have a bad download, but that has never happened to me, so I don't really know much about your problem.
Thank you.
What's this then, eh?
As you may have seen from the text here, but in 0.76 we do have formation back. So that's a good thing. Yes, when you load some of the missing texture, it won't let you play until you click OK for all the missing textures. So that's how it goes.
Thank you.
I'm not having the same luck as the last one, because I am finding not many things to kill. All the things are just too powerful for me right now. Might as well just move back to the land where I first started in Hakon Empire, so I can get some easy targets. Okay. That misclick, man, that misclick. So basically, this is one of the new feature of the 0.76. So this is a list of all the skills you can use in combat. That is all bind to these following keys. So if you have the requirement, the necessary requirement, you can activate these skills. I think the new skill feature will definitely be very useful, very interesting to all the players. Like, you can experiment new builds with these, you can actually use skills in a different way. I have just started, so yeah. So far so good. There hasn't been any OP codes or anything like that, so yeah. We'll see how it goes. Oops! Yeah, I started the stream, but not really streaming, because I was setting up things, and the network was a little bit spiky, so yeah. You might as well notice why I am using throwing weapons and not bow, because I spec into throwing weapons, because I am MLG pro. So yeah, let's do something original. So apparently these ladies have no family, so they're just there. That's strange. Yeah. For some reason, all the ladies are without family. So they're just there. They don't have a family. So I don't know, this might be a bug. Something is wrong with the script that assigned these ladies to their family, maybe. Because as you can see, literally no lady has a family. Yeah, this has no music except for the mod's music, so it's certainly should be uploaded. Yeah, this is 0.76. I have just compiled it and put it here with all the new fixes and things like that, and the new system and everything, formation and stuff. So you can see, like, this is what I was saying when I mentioned balancing. So these guy, in their equipment, they have throwing weapons, throwing spears, but they have no proficiency for that. Like, their proficiencies for throwing is non-existent. So that's what I am trying to do here, is to fix these things.
Everything has a price, even your life.
Yeah, I started anew and I was in another land, but now I come back to the Hakon land because that is the easiest place to get things done for a low level. So these guys are actually pretty ineffective because their weapon is too short for what matters. They need more reach so they can actually hit things. Well, I don't like redwoods because they are just bows and bows and bow. I like something with melee weapons. Something with muscles. Not bows. Bows for pussies. You can see with the new system, when you have too many items in your inventory, your speed will be heavily affected. So you move so slow. However, I don't think this justify this level of speed, so this is something that might need to be checked again over. Yeah, Valor here is an option, but I want something smarter. So I choose Machavian. Machavian is the smartest out of them. So apparently in this new version everything moves at the speed of snail for some reason. I don't know about the speed. Yep, I have just touched this version. I didn't work on this version, so I don't know what to expect. So this is way too slow. In my opinion, this is way too slow. There must be a reason for this though. Like my speed would gradually increase, but for some reason it dipped to around 2.0 after a battle. Now it's gone back up to like 5.96.0, so it's gradually going back up, but I know what is it that's going on. So this is something I might have to check again with the developers to see. Is this a new feature, or is this something that is not supposed to happen? Yeah, so my speed is back up to 7. So this is the most normal speed for just a few troops and myself at like with pathfinding at 4+1. Should be around 7 to 8. And yeah, I'm getting there, but there was something that slowed the party down for sometimes. I don't know what that is. This must be a new feature, most likely. And there's also that problem with the clipping. As you can see, this guy, the king has 500 troops in his party, and he is moving at zero speed. So this is definitely something that needs to be looked at. This is definitely game breaking. Like, you can see, like, the lord, they won't move out of the castle because they can't. They're too heavy. They literally has zero speed, so they are immobile. That's actually a problem, and I have to check on other castle to see whether that is a persistent problem. Apparently, the king of Tauranian is way too fat. That's the only explanation I can give, is he is way too fat, so he can't even lift his feet up and go and run. Back to slow speed, like everything is back to zero speed after a fight. Like everything. Everything is back to snail speed after a fight. Yeah, look at these guys. This guy is not even affected and he's still slow. Something is definitely wrong. The enemy dodges, but you still count as hitting the enemy. So the dodges happens after the hit. That's why you still get the message that you hit the target, but it actually dodges. Yeah, the price for troops is based on their level, so if you lower their level, then the price for them should be lowered. Or another fix that is also possible is that you give them some better equipments. So if they have more suitable equipments for their price, then nobody will complain about them. Yeah, the wages work the same. Like it is all based on the level of the troops. So if you lower their levels, then it definitely will go down. Same for any troops. There's definitely a lot more testing and balancing has to be done for this, and it's actually what I'm trying to do. Like, I'm trying to see what is not okay so that we can change it in time for the release. So this will be possibly released before school for most people. Not guarantee, but the lead developer did say that, so yeah. I'll see about the scouts. I know that they have very bad equipments and stats and at a very high level, so I'll change them. Probably gonna give them some more weapons and armors and some better stats so that they're worth the money, and lower their level as well. Hello, welcome to the stream. So this mod is called Perisno. It is a low to mid fantasy mod with lots of custom things. Like this is a total conversion, so you won't find anything native world banned about this mod. It has everything is already converted into the world of personal. That's all I can give you, because you have to download the mod to try it and see it for yourself. That's the basic of the mods. So this is the upcoming version that isn't out yet. It's the work in progress, but it's coming out very soon. It's the version 0.76. the currently working is version 0.75, and you can download it on ModsDB or Steam Workshop, I believe. So from that fight, you can see there's still one problem with the formation, that it is still making the NPC not charging at you, and there's just sitting far away from you, and make sure that you can just use your archer to hit them. This is, I don't know how you can solve this issues, because this is probably the most important thing in the formation AI mod, in the formation AI feature, that you have them attack at at the right time. And yeah, this is the Sultan is not moving. He's so fat, he can't even lift. Now he has 400 troops and is moving at zero speed. This is also the same bugs that happens to another party on the map already that has a lot of troops that it can't move for some reason. As you can see, we have tons of new models, new textures, and we have over 2,000 items added into the game. All kinds of weapons, armors, horses and camel, and occasionally you can even find wolves and goat and elephant and even dragon. You can find dragon mount that actually floating and not running on the ground, but floating. Okay, sure man, thank you for dropping by, appreciate you. See you on the next stream tomorrow. I'll be streaming tomorrow when I can. Hello. I'm not talking much because I am playing and I don't want to distract by talking. So if you have questions, please chat and I will try to answer them. Yeah, there's a lot of new things in 0.76 already. Some bugs, but other than that, there's a new features that I will show you very soon. When I get into a battle, I'll try to show you the new features. So this is a new feature. So with this feature you can actually use skills in combat by pressing these keys. Yep, each skill require a certain skill or certain attributes, as you can see here. This is entirely new to 0.76 and 0.8. I haven't tested this myself, but this looks very interesting and should make combat much more interesting and more relevant, especially in the late game where you have lots of skills. As you can see, I just press a button and you can already see the text means that I have activated one of the skills. Sadly, I'm dead. No, it will not be safe compatible because from 0.75 to 0.76, we move around a lot. We added new things and we move around all the items, so they are in different places comparing to 0.75. So if you try to use the old save for the new game, the new version, it will actually just broke your game. This is one of the problem, however, that after every battle, everything on the map seems to be moving at the speed of snail. Of course, there's still problems within this version, so I am just playing the game, testing it, streaming it, so I can find out what is the problem and trying to get a fix for it as soon as possible, so when we release it will be less of a hassle to put out fixes and hot fixes and patches for the mod. So yeah, and there's this new feature that we are debating whether it should be put into game. It's a very neat feature that the reference material, you can see all the troops categorized very easily. As you can see, it is all categorized, then every single troops is presented and it's interactable, so if you click onto one of the troops you can see exactly what it's like. Even has rating, all the stats. We also have a new system called the encumbrance effect, so this affects all the troops with how heavy is their armor and weapons relative to their strength. And if it's too heavy and or their strength is too low, then it will put a penalty on them. And the other way around, if they have very high strength and not wearing much, then they will get a bonus for their power. Yep, the most famous thing, the Drachenmeister with these dragons. You can actually see them, actually see everything. It covers all the troops in the game from every single faction, even bandits and other minor factions. Yeah, for example, here's the bandit tree, so you can see all the blue woods, all the Ankars. Akrian defenders is Arcanist troops, all the mercenaries, Yeah, all the mercenaries. That's basically it for now, but we plan to have even more expanded troopsies, troop reference that's gonna cover all the bandits as well as other minor factions such as Eagle, Demon, Foreign Invader and the like. We also have few old items which players might have already been familiar with, where you can view all the items in the game. So, well, Michael is here, so I will talk about this problem right here. So, you can see this is one of the problems. So, you can see the Queen of Redwood, she actually doesn't move. This is happening to most of the lords. Like, whenever a fight finished, whenever the player finished a fight, it seems like all the party on the map got reduced speed to like zero and started going back up slowly. But for some reason these big parties they won't get to go anywhere for a very long time. So we can see this is the queen, and I will try to fast forward to see whether she will move. As you can see, she just jumped. Yeah, very very slowly. It's actually buggy, I think. Something happened that is messing with the speed calculation on the world map of these parties. I'll try to find some parties that I can kill, and then we'll see the effect after that. That even the player party is also slowed down, then every other parties on the map are slowed down by that, which is pretty weird, I think. And glowing Helsing crossbow, definitely glowing Helsing crossbow. So this need some retextures. Oh yeah, string not found. Yeah, and this is the formation mod. So in the formation mod, the problem is still that for some reason the AI just not trying to charge at you. They just try to stay away from you. If they have archer in the army, they will definitely try to stay away from you. Yeah, you can see the speed is really slow after fighting. Like right after fighting, your speed is lowered down significantly. It will gradually increase back up. Yeah, you can see it gradually will increase back up, but it takes some time. Like you can see, these guys, they travel at the speed is way too slow. Even my party with just only 37 plus 3, and I have like 5 in pathfinding, and it's still moving too slow. It will gradually, the speed will gradually come back up. Yeah, but it takes some time. Yeah. Probably, I don't know what you change in the map speed, but it is affecting about everything. So everything moves way too slowly. Yeah, so here's another example. This guy used to have like 500 troops, now he has 400, but he's been moving at speed of light since forever, since the first time I saw him. He's been moving at the speed of infinity, and I don't know how does he move across, but just see. Yeah, he just jump. Yeah, that's all he does, jumping. jump. Zero speed for life. Okay guys, so I think I have to wrap up here because it's getting too late for me. In Ireland it's 1 a.m. here, so I need to get some sleep. I'll try to stream tomorrow at some point earlier than today at least, so that you can watch me doing some things in some actions, trying out new features of 0.76. I hope you have a good night, and see you again next time.